All right, welcome to lesson four, which is all about working with gradients and gradient meshes. Now, to get started here, you'll need to open up another project file. So go into your project files folder on your desktop, into part one, into the lesson four folder, and open up rottentomato.ai. And here's our Rotten Tomato character here, which we're going to fill with some colors here and make him look a little bit more interesting. So we'll get started here working with some basic gradients. Now, before we really get rolling here, I want to give you a quick tour of the layers palette just to show you how I've organized this file here. So go ahead and grab your layers palette. If you don't see it on your screen, head up to your window menu or hit F7 on your keyboard here. And the way that I've organized things is we have a text layer down at the very bottom, as well as a black outline layer for our tomato here, as well as the tomato fill, the leafy top, a little bit of drool. We actually have two drool layers, part two, and then part one is way up at the top there. We have the eyes and teeth, staples and such. So basically what I've done here for us is isolated all the different parts of our tomato here, and then what we'll be doing throughout this lesson is filling them with some gradients and, like I say, making them look a little bit more interesting, a little bit more dynamic here. So let's get started with working with some gradients. So the first thing that I'll have you do is just zoom in a little bit here on our Rotten Tomato character here. Now, the first thing that we'll do is work on our tomato fill for our rotten tomato here. So go and look for your tomato fill layer, and you can see that I've locked down two of my layers already, my black outline and my inside black lines as well. So if you want, you can click inside the lock column for your layers here, but make sure that the tomato fill layer is not locked because we want to be working on that one. And there's something else I want to show you here quickly regarding our tomato fill. I'm going to open up my tomato fill layer, and you can see the tomato fill layer is made up of several different objects here. So rather than isolating each one of them, I want to highlight them all at once. And to do that, I'm going to click on the little circle icon over to the right side of the tomato fill layer. And that highlights all of the items inside this tomato fill. Now, to give you a basic idea of how gradients work, we'll start off simply and then we'll get a little bit more complex as we go along. I'll move my layers out of the way here. And over in your swatches palette, we'll get started just by using one of the more simplistic gradients here, the simple black to white. So go ahead and click on that swatch there, and you can see that the tomato fill gets filled with this gradient. So it's a gradient that's going from pure white to pure black, from left to right. Not only that, but because we had selected all of the objects on the tomato fill layer, all of those objects have the same gradient applied to them. So actually getting a gradient applied to an object is fairly straightforward, but let's get a little bit more involved. I'm going to pull over my gradient palette here, and the gradient palette, if it's not visible on your screen, head up to your window menu and you'll find it listed in there. What the gradient palette does is shows me exactly what's happening inside my gradient fills. So towards the top here, I have my little gradient fill thumbnail. It's telling me that the type of gradient is linear. We'll talk more about that. The angle of my gradient right now is 0 degrees. And it's also telling me what colors are involved in my gradient down on this little gradient ramp that I have here. So you can do some neat things here with your gradients. First of all, these little boxes here down at the bottom of the gradient ramp, you can drag on these guys. These guys are called color stops. So I can move my little color stops around, and that determines back on my Rotten Tomato how much white or how much black is going to appear inside my gradient fill. I also have this little diamond at the top of my gradient slider. This little guy is called the midpoint skew. I always just call him the gradient diamond or the diamond here. I can drag them along my gradient slider here to again determine how much black or how much white I want inside my gradient. So as you can see, actually applying a gradient and manipulating it a little bit is fairly easy, but obviously a tomato is not solid black and solid white. We want to throw in a little bit of color. Now there's a number of different ways that we can do this. Probably one of the easiest ways to do this is I'm going to click on my black color stop on the right side of my gradient palette. And what I'll do is pull up my color palette. Again, if you don't have it available, go to your window menu. Here it's telling me that the color stop that I selected on the gradient ramp is pure black. Now, I don't want this guy to be black. I want to use a color. So here's a neat little trick that you can do. I want to switch to a different color mode inside my color palette here. So I'm going to hold down my shift key, and I'm going to click anywhere along the color ramp at the bottom of the color palette here. Click once. There's RGB. Click again. HSB. Hue, saturation, and brightness. Click again, CMY case, I am magenta, yellow, black. Click again, I'm back on RGB. So whichever color space or color mode you'd prefer to work in, it's really up to you. I'm going to work in CMYK here, and like I say, I don't want pure black here. Instead, I want to go for sort of a reddish tone here for my tomato. So I'll drag my CMYK sliders here a little bit until I find the color that I'm after. Or, of course, I can select a color using the color ramp down at the bottom here. A neat thing that you can do here in Illustrator is drag along the color ramp as I'm doing here and get a preview of the cyan, magenta, yellow, and black breakdown. So I wanted a reddish color here, so I'll go and find one down on the left side here. There we are. As you can see, the gradient in the background in my artwork updates automatically, so it's looking pretty good. But I don't want to be going from pure white to pure red. I'd like to make it look a little bit more realistic here. So I'm going to do the same thing now with my white color stop. So I'll single click here, and once again, I will shift click on the color ramp at the bottom of the color palette, and I'll keep shift clicking until I get myself over to the CMYK sliders. And then I'll go and find another reddish type color that I'd like to use, maybe something a little bit darker. Now you can see there that my two colors are pretty close together, so I better find something a little bit different. Maybe more of an orangish color there. There we go. So you can see it's going from this orange or this scarlet color all the way down on the right side to this deep red here. I'll organize my palettes here. So there's a few easy ways for changing the colors inside your gradients.